Over the past few years, many people have requested MrBeast to make an Ultra Reality server. If you don't know what Ultra Reality is, it is basically a virtual reality world that you can enter physically and transform into a video game character, much like the anime known as SAO, minus the dystopian aspects. Now, previously I made videos discussing what if Ultra Reality had a Smash Bros. Format, but many people seem to not get the point of those videos, so I decided to make UR its own thing called Nintendotopia, which, as the name implies, is a utopia for Nintendo fans that is more like VR chat than Smash Bros., the hub world being modeled after Tokyo, Japan. I noticed a lot of Nintendo fans live in an area where they are the only person who likes Nintendo. Not only will this let Nintendo fans be in a physical location where they can make friends who share their interests as their favorite character, but also I really want to see Jimmy 2 some Nintendo stuff. I think that would be really fun. Now, I am sure many of my YouTube viewers will be familiar with a YouTuber named VineSauce. Recently, VineSauce uploaded a video where he took part in a MrBeast VR chat challenge. I'm not going to get too ahead of myself, but after the recent VineSauce video, there is no doubt in my mind that there is something in the works for UR on the horizon. Because of this, from now on, every single video I will be adding whoever the number one most requested character for Nintendotopia is that specific day. Currently, the number one most requested character in Nintendotopia is the legendary Agent 3, more commonly known as Inkling from Splatoon. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you enjoy. Let's get into it. Now, I'm sure many of the people watching this video are MrBeast fans who know nothing about Inkling or Splatoon. There is a lot of interesting bits of information about the Splatoon series, so be sure to listen to what I have to say, because I have a lot to talk about if you want to know who Inkling and the Splatoon series is. Inkling, known in her game's universe as Agent 3, is the protagonist of the Splatoon series. The original Splatoon game was a launch title for the Wii U to show off the console's functionalities. It is a third-person shooter where you control squid kids known as Inklings, and your goal in the main game mode, Turf War, is to cover the most turf with ink. I pay a lot of attention to the competitive Splatoon community. I know a lot of MrBeast fans might be interested to hear that many Nintendo games have a sizable competitive community, as that is not common knowledge. In competitive Splatoon, Turf War is actually the least favored game mode. Instead, they play ranked modes such as Rainmaker, Splat Zones, Clam Blitz, and my personal favorite, Tower Control. The reason it's my favorite is I find it best for my playstyle and weapon preferences. The Splatoon series also has a story mode, which is the game's main single player mode. While I am a bit surprised that Inkling got the number one spot the first time around, it does make sense due to the series' popularity and the incredible amount of character customization. I was thinking in Nintendotopia, each character could have a set of different outfits, which are all outfits that are in their original game. I was also thinking of giving all female humanoid characters queen outfits based on Melia and Nia's outfits from Xenoblade Chronicles 3. Currently, the only characters in Nintendotopia eligible for this are Eiyumi, Zelda, and Corrin, but I will let you all know when another character who is eligible for a queen outfit gets in the number one spot for most requested. But either way, Inkling in Nintendotopia is hype. Thank you guys for watching this video. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, and as always, stay chill, everyone.